Hey guys, welcome back to Top 10 Nerd. I'm your host Kelly Pally, and today we've got the top 10 best superhero costumes for you. Yes, that's right, the best superhero costumes, not villains, keep that in mind. And a bit of warning, yes, Superman is not on this list. Well, yeah, I know his costume is arguably the most iconic, and him being the first superhero ever to appear in comics is definitely responsible for setting the bar for what kind of costumes illustrators would later use on other superheroes, but it's also a bit of an obvious choice, so we're just gonna leave him entirely off this list for this one. But don't worry, we definitely hit on some other fan favorites. So here we go. Starting off this list, we've got the Comedian. Here's a realistic take on what a vigilante would actually wear. While his costume in The Minutemen is a bit more fitting of the Silver Age of superheroes, Edward Blake's Crime Stoppers in Vietnam suit is pretty bad and fully loaded. Eddie Blake is actually one of the only vigilantes in Watchmen that stays masked throughout his career. Most of the Minutemen eventually reveal their identities, as well as some of the crime busters, but Blake ends up working for the government on several specific missions after he wraps up his costume career, so staying anonymous is pretty important. And at number 9, we have Daredevil. Daredevil makes this list for having a costume that is actually pretty terrifying for most of the criminals he encounters. Imagine seeing Daredevil lurking in the shadows right before he kicks your butt. It'd be pretty damn traumatizing. Many fans of Daredevil were disappointed by Matt Murdock's costume in the Netflix show when it was finally revealed at the end of season 1, especially since the concept art was released in 2016 and it shows that the original designs of the costume were much closer to the contemporary version of the costume that Matt wears in the comics. And at number 8, we have Hellboy. Okay, so a lot of his badass aesthetic can be chopped up to the fact that he's a literal demon, but his classic trench coat is oh so fitting for the character's persona. It's hard to imagine Hellboy really rocking anything else authentically. Unlike our previous number, Guillermo del Toro's 2004 film adaptation managed to get the costume pretty spot on, and was well received by Hellboy's fans. And let's be honest, Hellboy is one of the most underrated superhero films out there. You should definitely give it a watch if you haven't already seen it. Number 7, Martian Manhunter. Manhunter makes this list primarily for the fact that he stands out. Not just because he's a super powerful green alien capable of shapeshifting. No, this is because he has one hell of an eye for color. The combination of red and blue against his iconic green skin has made Martian Manhunter a character that really jumps off the page. Newer versions of the suit, like the one featured on the Supergirl TV show, tends to drive away from the classic blue and red outfit, which was a choice made to modernize Manhunter and avoid making him look cheesy. But hey, when you're as badass and caring of a character as Ja'an is, I'm pretty sure you can get away with wearing whatever the hell you want. Number 6, Iron Man. Here's a hero who relies on his suit for very practical reasons, or rather, all of the reasons, being the source of Tony Stark's power. It's come a long way from the original Iron Man suit that first appeared in Tales of Suspense number 39 back in March 1936. Luckily, illustrators improved upon the suit, giving it some more shape and color as Iron Man progressed as a character in the comics. The film version of Stark's beloved suit has definitely been approved by most fans too. Aside from its visual appearance, Stark's suit is a scientific feat, and it raises a lot of questions about how the government should use militarized technology. And at 5, we've got Storm. Minus being at times a little unrealistic in terms of practicality for fighting crime, every reincarnation of Storm's outfit has stood the test of time, and usually it contains aerodynamic components that definitely aid in the use of some of her powers. Generally sticking within the blacks, whites, and silvers, Storm has always kept it classy, even when she's rocking a mohawk, which is definitely something else worth noting. Her hair game is always on point. And at 4, we've got Spider-Man. This list wouldn't be complete without a shout-out to Spider-Man and Peter Parker. Spider-Man gets points for creativity. Think about it, guys. Stan Lee could have made a dire mistake with this one. A man with spider powers could have turned out a lot more gruesome looking than he did. But the blue-red color combo and the web print on the suit is definitely more aesthetically appealing. And those eyes, come on, definitely a riveting design. Similar to our next number on this list, Spidey has had many variations of his costume over the years, especially in the feature films. Fans were a lot happier with the Andrew Garfield reincarnation of the suit more than the one Tobey Maguire wore. At number 3 is Batman. Let's take a brief look at the history of Bruce Wayne's cape and cowl. Over the past 78 years, Batman has had multiple variations of his suit, right down to the style of his utility belt, his boots, and his bladed gloves. Within the first year and a half of his creation, his suit changed 3 times in terms of color, bat logo, and distance between his bat ears on his cowl. The best part is that all of the variants of the bat suit have managed to retain the essential qualities that make Batman so great, even during his more campier phases in the 60s.
A routine question. Have you recently sold any war surplus submarines, and if so, to whom?
At number two, we've got Wonder Woman. Wonder Woman makes this list not only because her costume is incredibly iconic and memorable, but because it comes from some really fascinating origins. From her first appearance in 1942 in Sensation Comics, Wonder Woman has always been critiqued for her outfit. Back then, it was that she wasn't wearing enough clothes. Unfortunately, over the years, that didn't change much, and a lot of the reincarnations of her costume got progressively smaller and sexier. But the truth is, Wonder Woman has always had a subtle sexual connotation due to her creator and American psychologist, Dr. William Moulton Marston. Marston was heavily into bondage, and some of these influences seeped into his characterization of the heroine. From her bracelets of submission to the lasso of truth that she uses to tie up her opponents, it's not too far of a reach to see how Marston personified his desires into Wonder Woman's outfit and accessories. Finally, at number one, we have a costume that is as iconic as Superman's, Wolverine. While it may not stand the test of time in later adaptations, Wolverine's classic yellow and blue suit is one that has always had a special place in the hearts of many fans. It's also made for some really great tongue-in-cheek jokes in the X-Men films over the years.
You actually go outside in these things? What would you prefer? Yellow spandex?
Wolverine and his suit made their debut in a 1974 issue of The Incredible Hulk, when Hulk crosses the border into Canada and Wolverine jumps out of the forests of Quebec to aid him in battling a Wendigo. So there you guys have it, the top 10 superhero costumes. I personally really love this one, guys, so if you want more superhero costume lists, make sure you give us a shout in those comments below. And if you dug this video, don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons, and make sure you click on that bell notification so you never miss another nerdy list. I'll catch you guys in the next one.